Fear the anointing, the power of God, the glory of Jesus. It's amazing. It's amazing. It's amazing. Get ready, saints. Awesome anointing. Powerful teaching. Powerful impartation. Then we're out of here. Saints, bless you. What an awesome Jesus we serve. Jesus is Lord. I worship you. Oh, yes. Mighty God, oh, there is none like you. Oh, yes, oh, yes. I worship you, oh, Prince of Peace. Ooh. This is what I long to do. I give you praise, oh yes, oh yes, yes, for you are my righteousness. I worship you. Oh, Prince of Peace, there is none like you. I worship you, oh yes. Prince of Peace, oh, there is none like you, I worship you, oh yes, Prince of Peace, ooh. Oh yes, this is what I long to do. I give you praise, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, for you are my righteousness. I worship you, Prince of Peace, oh, there is none like you. Oh, saints, this is going to be so amazing. There's none like you. Oh, my God. I feel the anointing. Get ready, saints. You are blessed. Oh, yes. Get ready. How's everyone doing? How's everyone doing? Saints, saints, as the Lord lives. I believe the anointing of favor is on me, because one of my jewelers gave me this. Now this ring, it had a value of thousands, and he gave it to me for free. Yeah, now you ain't hear what I said. I ain't say I paid no down payment. I said it had, he gave it to me for free. I ain't talking about $5. I ain't talking about $2. I ain't paid $1 as the Lord lives. I thought he was crazy, so I walked out real quick. I got out real quick. Then he tried to call me on the phone, I answered. Because you know sometimes when God rip it out the devil's hand, and they try to call you. Nah. I worship you, mighty God. Oh, there is none like you. Oh, I worship you. The same favor is on you. Prince of Peace, oh, this is what I long to do. I give you praise, oh, for you are my righteousness. I worship you, oh yes, yes, Prince of Peace. Ooh, there is none like you. I worship you, oh yes, mighty God, oh, there is none like you, oh yes. I worship you, Prince of Peace, ooh, oh yes, this is what I long to do. I give you praise, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes. Ooh. Oh, I worship you, oh yes, yes, Prince of Peace. Ooh, there is none like you. Ooh, 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 ooh.
Says, get ready for what the Lord is about to do. Get ready, get ready, get ready. Saints, bless everyone. I know you've been feeling the anointing. I know that you've been feeling the anointing. I know you have. I know you have. No matter what's been happening to you, I know you've been feeling the anointing. I know you've been feeling the anointing. I know that you've been feeling God's power. I know you have. Because saints, knowledge helps Jesus transfer to you what's in the spirit to your natural realm. Isn't this powerful, saints? That's why the Bible said my people perish for lack of knowledge. Well, he was saying, I can't get it to you until you have a knowledge. You're going to perish until the knowledge comes. The knowledge is going to be the channel which I transferred to you. Oh yes, yes. Oh yes. Glory. Glory. Oh yes, yes. Glory to the Lamb. Glory, glory, oh yes, yes, glory to the Lamb. Ooh, for you are glorious, oh yes, yes. You're worthy to be praised. You're the Lamb upon the throne. Unto you we lift our voice in praise. Oh, you're the Lamb upon the throne.
Pick up the key.
You are glorious. Oh yes, yes. Oh yes, yes. Oh yes, yes. You're the Lamb upon the throne. Oh yes, yes. Oh yes, yes. Unto you we lift our voice in praise. Oh, you're the Lamb upon the throne. You're the Lamb upon the throne. Oh, you're the Lamb upon, oh, you're the Lamb upon the throne. Oh yes, you're the Lamb.
Bear the anointing, bear the anointing. The lion realm, the lion of the tribe of Judah. Everything that God is going to do for you is going to be connected to Judah. If you want to release the realm of God, of him being a lion, you have to walk in the realm of God, of Judah. Praising him, thanking him, being grateful, being humble about what he does for you. So Judah is connected to lion. The lion realm of God is connected to Judah. Apostle Paul knew this, so he praised God in the prison and he released the lion. Remember Cisco said, unleash the dragon, we're unleashing the lion. That's old school.
Oh yes, glory. Glory, oh yes, yes. Glory to the Lamb. Oh. Glory, oh yes, yes. Glory, oh. Glory to the Lamb. Glorious, you're worthy to be praised. You're the Lamb upon the throne. Oh, oh. Unto you we lift our voice in praise. You're the Lamb upon the throne. For you are glorious, oh yes, yes, worthy to be praised. You're the Lamb upon all the throne, oh yes, yes, oh yes. Unto you we lift our voice in praise. You're the Lamb upon, oh, you're the Lamb upon the throne. Ooh. You're the Lamb. Oh, you're the Lamb upon the throne. Oh, you're the Lamb upon. Saints, those of you all that's joining on, bless you, every single person. The power of Jesus Christ is going to penetrate your weekend tonight. You're going to carry another level of his substance, his power, his wisdom, his knowledge. Are you ready? Are you ready? Your thirst days and your cursed days are over. Your thirst days, your cursed days, and your worst days are over. Your all those things. Your thirst days. Your cursed days. All those things are over. This old things have passed away. This is what the Holy Spirit said. Tell you that old things have passed away. And you ain't even got to go to the funeral. You hear me? This is powerful stuff. The cursed days is over. And you don't even got to go to the funeral. Don't remember the things of old. Don't remember the things of old. Let our King be lifted up, oh, Hosanna, oh yes. Let our King be lifted up, oh, Hosanna. Hosanna, Hosanna, in the highest. Let our King be lifted up, oh yes, Hosanna. Hosanna, Hosanna, ooh, in the highest, highest, highest. Let our King be lifted up, oh, Hosanna.
Powerful anointing.
Hosanna, Hosanna, oh yes, yes. You're in the highest level, highest level, highest. Let our King be lifted, oh yes, oh.
Hosanna. Hosanna. Hosanna, oh yes, in the highest, his level, highest level, highest, let our King be lifted up, oh, oh, Hosanna. Feel the anointing. Hosanna, Hosanna, oh yes, in the highest. Feel the anointing. Highest, let our King be lifted up, oh yes. Saints, bless you. Feel the power of God. This is prophetic level 12. Oh, let our King be lifted up. Let our King be lifted up. Let our King. Oh, yes. Oh yes, you are God alone. Oh yes. Oh yes.
I'm the only prophet you know that could text and teach at the same time.
Oh yes.
I need 100 people. Share this on Facebook. Retweet this on Twitter.
Oh yes, the good times and bad. You are on the throne. Oh yes.
What scripture did you meditate on today? What's the scripture that you meditated on today? What scripture did you focus on today? What scripture? What's your scripture for today?
Oh yes, you are God alone. Oh yes, unchangeable, unstoppable, that's who you are. Oh yes, oh yes. Unshakable.
This is going to be so powerful. I feel the anointing. I feel the anointing for tonight. Get ready, saints. Those of you all that's joining on, say, I received the prophet's word. I just need 100 people to share this on Facebook. Share this on Facebook. And retweet this on Twitter. You have a Twitter account. Retweet this on Twitter.
Oh, yes, yes. Unstoppable. That's who you are. Oh, yes. Unshakable, unchangeable, unstoppable, that's who you are.
Jesus, we welcome you. We thank you so much for everything that you have done for us this week. You kept us alive. You fed us, you clothed us, you protected us, you gave us your spirit, your mercy. We praise you right now. We thank you for everything, Lord. Thank you so much. Thank you, Lord. Thank you so much. We thank you. We glorify you. We know it's you that have shown us kindness and love. Thank you for showing us kindness and love. Thank you for showing us grace and favor. Thank you, Lord, for showing us so much of your goodness. Thank you so much, Father. We magnify you. We choose to be different. We choose to be faithful. Not pursue you just for blessing, but be pursuing you because you pursued us. We make a choice right now to be vessels of honor, not dishonor. And we say thank you for the opportunity to be your friend in the earth, You said, ye are my friends if you do whatsoever I command you to do. You simplified friendship. You made it easy. You said, if we do whatever you command us, then we can be a friend. You made it easy. We receive the easiness of friendship. Oh, yes, you are God alone. Oh, yes, you're mighty. You're mighty. You're mighty. You're mighty. Oh, you're mighty. You're mighty. You're mighty. We thank you. Oh, yes, we thank you, Jesus, for all you've done for me. Oh, we thank you, Lord. Oh, Jesus, you're awesome. Friendship. Oh, we thank you for all you've done for me. Ooh. Oh, yes, yes. We thank you for all you've done. Bless you all, saints. I'm excited about this. Whenever your pursuit of Jesus changes, your anointing changes. Whenever your anointing changes, your assignment changes. Whenever your assignment changes, your blessing changes. Whenever your blessing changes, your connection changes. Ooh, we love you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus, for all you've done for me. Oh, yes. Thank you, Lord. What a faithful Jesus we serve. What a faithful Jesus we serve. Saints, those of you all that need healing in your body, you're going to receive it. Whatever you need Jesus to do for you, just having the faith to trust him for it right now is going to manifest. Just having the faith. Just having the faith. Just having the faith. Jesus, oh yes. All glorious. Creating us your temple, called as living stones where you're enthroned. Oh, yes, oh, yes. As you rose from death in power, rise within our worship, rise upon our praise, oh, and let the hand that saw you raise, clothe us in your glory, your glory. Draw us by your grace. So powerful, saints. So powerful. Jesus. Jesus. Oh, yes. All glorious. Oh, creating us a temple. Such a beautiful song. Called as living stones where you're enthroned. Oh yes, oh yes, yes. As you rose from death to power, as you rose from death to power, rise within, rise within our worship. Rise upon our praise, and let the hand that saw you raise, clothe us with your glory. Draw us by your grace. Oh, Jesus. Oh, the glory. Oh, yes, yes. Of your presence.
give you reverence. So arise, so arise to your rest, home, and be blessed by our praise as we hold in your embrace. Let your presence hold. I feel the anointing. Let's just worship for just a little while. Let's just worship. I feel the anointing on this. Let's just worship. Let's just worship. Jesus, oh yes, oh glorious, creating us your temple, called as living stones where you're enthroned. As you rose, oh yes, from death to power, rise within. Our worship, ooh, rise upon our praise, oh, and let the hand that saw you raise, clothe us with your glory. Oh, draw us by your grace. I feel the anointing, saints. It's so beautiful, so powerful. We say, you're Jesus. Oh yes, you're glorious, creating us a temple called as living stones where you're enthroned. Oh yes, yes, yes. Ooh, ooh, ooh. As you rose, oh yes, from death to power, rise within our worship. Rise upon our praise, oh, and let the hand that saw you raised, ooh, clothe us with your glory. Oh yes, draw us by your grace. Saints, I want you to share this broadcast. Say, Lord, I receive the prophetic word. Get the gospel out. Oh, the glory. Oh, yes, yes. Of your presence. We your temple. We give you reverence, so rise, oh,
Jesus, we glory. In your embrace. As your presence that fills this place. I feel the anointing. I feel the anointing. We're going to sing this song one more time. Hey, I feel the anointing. Listen, I'm going to sing this song one more time. The power of God falling. Jesus, all glorious, creating us a temple called as living stones where you're enthroned. I'm trying to memorize the words. I'm trying to learn these words. oh yes, yes. As you rose from death to power, rise within our worship. Share this broadcast, saints. Invite your followers. Rise upon our praise, oh, and let the hand that saw you raise, clothe us with your glory, oh, and draw us by your grace. Oh, saints, this is so powerful. This is so powerful. Jesus, oh, you're glorious, all glorious, creating us. Let him create in you a temple. Called as living stones. You're living stones. Where you're enthroned. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes. Oh Lord, we love you. As you rose, oh, from death to power, please rise within, oh, our worship. Rise upon our praise, and let the hand that saw you raise, ooh, clothe us with your glory, draw us back your grace. Oh yes, oh the glory. Oh yes, oh yes. Of your presence we give you reverence. So arise, so arise, ooh, to your rest and be blessed by our praise. Yeah. Hey, listen, I'm gonna play this song one more time. That man told one of my daughters, "You ain't with no Jesus." Jesus, all glorious. Oh, yes, yes. Creating us your temple. Where you're enthroned. As you rose from death to power, rise within our worship. Rise upon our praise. Oh, oh. Let the hand that saw you raise. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Clothe us with your glory. Glory,
Surge, I see the prophetic angel pouring oil on your head right now. Right in your place, I see the angel pouring oil, the prophetic oil. The prophetic oil of the Spirit, the seer's anointing. The Lord said, I'll birth in you my realm of seeing. I'll take you further than your father. I'll take you further than those that you have seen in ministry. I'll increase the dimension of my spirit within you. Lord said, as you have cried out for me and you have longed for me, Lord said, I shall visit you. You shall see me. I shall open your eyes, and your spirit shall carry me in a realm that many will misunderstand. Persecution will come. Hatred will be seen. Jealousy will arise. Those that once were with you will not be able to understand where I shall take you. But the Lord shall say, I shall go with you. I shall raise you higher and higher. I shall bless you with sweet marriage. I shall increase you financially. I shall cause your grace to bless many. These angels shall follow you from tonight. Saith the Spirit of the living God.
Oh, 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 yes, oh. The glory, oh, oh yes, of your presence. We your temple.
Serge, I see you putting on a golden robe in this season. A golden robe. The Lord said, my manifest presence shall be with you. Healing shall flow from you. Deliverance shall manifest from your hands. The sick shall recover because of your hands. I'm seeing you beginning to travel this year. You're beginning to travel this year, and as you're traveling, I'm seeing these angels go with you. I'm seeing you minister and begin to speak prophetically to people, to begin to tell them deep details about who they are.
I'm seeing the Lord Jesus embody you and personally possess you. Just as Samuel began to talk about there was a different spirit upon Saul. He became a different man. I'm seeing the Lord do the same thing for you. The impartation that shall come upon you shall make you a different. The vessel of prophecy is done. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes. Oh. This is going to be so powerful. Saints, get ready for what the Lord is going to do. I want to teach you some deep things about the prophetic. We're just worshiping for a little while, giving Jesus his due. The Bible says, give honor where honor is due. Jesus is worthy of honor. This is going to be so amazing. I'm going to be talking to you about prophetic mysteries. I'm going to talk to you about the different forms and functions of demons and the forms and functions of angels. Not every angel is tall. Not every angel is skinny. Not every angel is muscular. Not every angel is a male. There are female angels. A lot of people miss that the Bible said God created man, male and female. He created them. God created males and females in the man realm. Do you don't think that he created males and females in the female realm? But I'm going to show you in scripture. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Of your presence. Ooh. We're your temple. We give you reverence. So arise, oh, so arise to your rest. Ooh, and be blessed. Since this is the best night of your life. No matter what you see, no matter what you feel, this is the best moment. This is the best night. This is the best era of your life. Bless you, everyone. As you're joining on, share the gospel. Get the gospel out. Invite your followers. I'm ready to impart a deep realm to you. A real deep realm of Jesus. I'm locked and loaded. Once Jesus fills you up, it's over. It's over. Saints, the devil's scared for you to get full up of Jesus. He loved for you to be full up of flesh. He loved for you to be full up of distraction. When you get full of Jesus, it's over. That's his worst fear. Jesus, we bless you. Oh. bless you, saints. I decree blessings over your life. I decree favor upon your life. May goodness and mercy follow you. May you experience every heart desire. Oh, Jesus, you're awesome. Yay. Yes, the anointing, power of God. Let's go right back there. Let's go right back there. I feel the anointing, saints. Get ready. for what God is going to do in your life. This is the best week of your life. Angels shall fight for you. The Holy Spirit shall love on you. Jesus shall be your focus. Nothing shall separate you. Nothing shall hinder you. Nothing shall delay you. This is it. Oh, Jesus, we worship you. That's so powerful. To worship you, I live. You was created for worship. Oh, yes, oh, yes, oh, yes, yes. Oh, oh, Jesus. Such a mighty presence. Just say, Jesus, I receive your fullness. I receive. Saints, I'm a minister of powerful word. I feel it. I feel the anointing. Glory unto God. Saints, as you're joining our Shedish broadcast, invite your followers and say, Jesus, I receive your prophet's reward upon my life. That's from Matthew chapter 10, verse 41. You receive a prophet in the name of a prophet, you receive a prophet's reward. Receive it. Saints, oh yes, oh yes, yes, oh, 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 Saints, this is so powerful. You welcome Jesus, nothing can stop you. When you welcome Jesus, there's nothing that can stop you. Malakalamasia. I feel like my heart is exploding. Hey, I feel, listen, Saints, there's a mighty anointing on this. I feel my heart exploding. We got to do this one more time. There's a mighty anointing on this. I feel an explosion of Holy Spirit fire on my body. This is going to be such a life-changing night. Those of you all that's viewing, there's a touch from Jesus that you never experienced before that's going to start moving through you all this week. There's a touch. As you're joining on, share this broadcast. Invite your followers. Saints, that's how heaven gonna be, just jamming 24/7. I promise you, I've been there, I've seen it. Just jamming, concert, 24/7, I promise you. Saints, what God does, he prepares. That's why the Bible said the Father seeking those that will worship him in spirit and in truth. It's just gonna be a 24/7 concert. Just straight concert. And Saints, you ever been to your favorite concert, you don't wanna leave? That's gonna be heaven.
Oh, 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 yes, oh, yes.
yes, oh yes, oh, oh,
oh. Gonna be a straight concert.
Oh, oh, oh. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, yes.
Man, I feel the anointing. I don't know if y'all feel that, saints. There's an anointing. There's an anointing.
To worship you. To worship you.
And when you have no words left, just say, oh.
There's angels all around. There's so many angels here, saints. So many angels here. So many angels. Such a mighty anointing. Jesus, we praise you. Jesus, we praise you. Jesus, we glorify you. You're glorious. You're amazing. You're amazing. The awesome King. The real prophet. The real apostle. Is Jesus. The real pastor. Is Jesus.
Oh, saints, we got to sing this one last time before we go. Before we go into this message. We got to play this thing one more time. One more game, about 5 more minutes.
To worship you. To worship you. To worship you. To worship you.
About 5 more minutes. Jesus, we love you. Wow. Play this song one more time. You, those of y'all that don't like to worship, that's your fault.
To worship you.
That's why you're going to hell, because you don't like to worship. You want to just up there have a one night stand with Jesus and him bless you, and you not give him no praise. Huh? No, you're going to worship. You're going to bow down and worship tonight. Huh? You're going to bow down and worship tonight. Huh? All this drama. You people on Facebook just love dusting this. Y'all going to worship tonight. Oh, yes. All that gossip you receive in your spirit. Receive some worship. Huh? Huh? Saints, when you worship, you remind Lucifer what he can't do. Because he can't worship no more. Worship remind Lucifer of what he been replaced. So when you worshiping, you remind him that you the replacement. See, Lucifer had a replacement. It was me and you. He can't take it. So I'm going to play this song one more again. Somebody slap your neighbor and say one more again. One more guess. Malakala dala maso tolomo dile bekile maso tolomo. Hey.
To worship you I live. To worship you. Oh yes, yes.
Bless you, Rhonda. Rhoda.
To worship you.
That's a good word.
I live to worship you. Oh yes. Oh yes, I worship you.
Come on, say this worship one more time.
Oh. Ooh.
Says there's an anointing. Listen, some of y'all can feel the you can feel the power of God. Says, I'm telling you, it is tangible. It's tangible. And 5 more minutes. We're gonna use this 5 more minutes for a good cause. Some of y'all testifying that you're feeling the anointing. It's amazing, right? The presence of God before you go to church tomorrow. Hey, glory to God, because it's not really a place, it's a grace. Jesus Christ.
Oh yes.
Since there's a buildup of power on this line right now. There's a buildup. While we worshiping, I'm stepping into those waters. Elisha told Naaman to dip 7 times because there's 7 levels. 7 prophetic levels. I'm stepping into those waters. You're being delivered from smoking cigarettes. I heard that. You're being delivered from smoking cigarettes. You're being delivered from nicotine demons. Oh, yeah. You're being delivered from the soul type. You're being delivered from a man you've been connected to for years, from a woman you've been connected to for years. You're being set free from religious friendships that stagnate you. Marcus, what you just said? Marcus, I'm going to have you copy and paste your stuff from now on. Listen, Marcus, what you doing dealing with cougars and whatnot? Huh? You're being set free from religious friendships that stagnate you. There's an anointing to set you free. Marcus, I deliver you from that cougar spirit. Huh? You're going to be delivered today. Everybody pray for Marcus. Yeah, hey Marcus. In Jesus' name. Oh, yes, yes. Being delivered from cigarettes. Cigarettes is being eradicated from your life. Wrong thoughts, wrong ways, wrong friendships, wrong emotions. In Jesus' name, a purging of your memory. That your memory will be purged. In Jesus' name. Somebody said, Daniel, you're in prison and you also use the smartphone. I've been getting letters from people in prison. I don't know how they watch. But I receive letters from people in jail that watch the ministry. I don't know how they do it. But listen, bootleg phone service, blessed be God. You got to get it how you live. No, saints, as the Lord lives, I got a message. That's a blessing. Gospel on the move. To worship you, I live. To worship you. I live to worship you. Oh, yes. When you have no words left, just say, oh, 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 oh. Oh, yes, oh, yes, oh, yes. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, yes, oh, yes. Oh, yes. I'm about to teach, saints. Let's just worship for it. Oh, yes, oh, yes, oh, yes, yes. Saints, receive your deliverance right now in Jesus' name from anything that has been stopping you. Receive deliverance right now. Receive the anointing of deliverance right now, wherever you are. Anything that's been disturbing you right now in Jesus' name, receive the anointing of deliverance. Receive the anointing of deliverance right now. Receive the anointing of deliverance right now. Wherever you are, angels of deliverance, angels of deliverance, angels of deliverance, set you free right now in the name of Jesus. Angels of deliverance right now is set you free. The angels of God set you free and delivers you from all evil. That's what Psalm 34 verse 7 says. The angel of the Lord encamps around those that fear him to deliver them. In the name of Jesus, I decree and I declare, you are delivered from not only financial demons, mental demons, soul demons, flesh demons, emotional demons. I decree and I declare you are delivered right now by the power of the Holy Spirit right now. In the name of Jesus, you are delivered. You are set free. No longer bondage. No longer bondage. Be still and know that I am your God. Oh yes. Be still and know that I am your God. Be still and know that I am your God. Be still. Such a strong presence of God. Know I am your God. Be still and know I am your God. Oh, be still and know that I am your God. Be still and know that I am your God. Be still and know that I am your God. Be still and know that I am your God. Be still and know I am your God. Be still and know that I am your God. Such a power of Jesus Christ. Such a power of Jesus Christ. Let's play that song again. For those of y'all that don't like to worship, I'm getting on your nerves. Because you only call God when you need something. You don't call Him when ain't nothing happening. You only call God when you need help. You don't call God when you don't need help. See, when you're true, you don't need a situation to call God. You call Him just to say, Jesus, how you doing? What's up with you? How can I be a blessing to you today, Lord? Huh? What you think, saints? You run away. Don't you run away from people that always got needs? Huh? Don't your uncle... Hey, listen, when Tyrone call you, when Tyrone call you, and he always asking you for $5, don't you run? And Tyrone, listen, you already know what he's going to ask you for. I need $5 more. Listen, Tyrone, I gave you $5 yesterday. Well, you start running from Tyrone because all you know he's going to come for $5. So, when you come to Jesus, that's all you got to do. That's all you got to say to Him. All you got to do is just tell Him your needs. That's all you can say to Jesus. That's all you can say to Him. You ain't got nothing else to say. He tired of you coming around here. No praise, no thanksgiving. You got to switch it up, woman of God. Switch it up, man of God. Stop being dusty. God, He don't want to hear all that stuff when you come to Him every single minute. He's looking to hear some praise. Praise Him for your situation. Praise Him that you're coming out your situation. Don't you believe? Or you just going to keep on telling Him what He already know? How about you tell Him what He said and praise Him on what He said instead of telling Him what He already know you broke. He already know you sick. He already know that you frustrated. You gonna keep on coming to Him with the same stuff? Don't you get irritated? Saints, you ever seen a little child when they start whining? You see people tell the child, stop whining. But saints, but you don't think that God be doing that? Huh? You don't think that God be like, stop whining. The children of Israel, they got hemmed up because they kept on whining. That's why God swallowed them. They kept on whining. They kept on complaining. They didn't know how to praise God and say, Lord, thank you for sending Prophet Moses to me. Thank you for delivering me out of the hands of Pharaoh. Thank you for calling me to walk this walk with you. Thank you for allowing me to see what I'm seeing. Thank you for allowing me to be tested. Thank you for trusting me enough to receive your instruction. See, there's a difference. You got to mature. When you go to God with that beggy spirit, that complaining spirit, you're still a baby. And babies don't go nowhere. God ain't going to trust you with the glory of being a baby. Because He know that if you baby, you childish. You're going to get a little power in your life, you're going to act childish with the power. You get a little money in your hand, you're going to act childish with the money. You get a little marriage, you're going to act childish with the marriage. You get a little, you get a little good. Huh? You don't know how to handle it. You think that you the stuff now. Huh? You hear what I said? That's why God needs to mature you first. You can't be up there. You can't be up there immature. Now God got to mature you. He got to mature you. You can't be up there. Oh yes. Oh yes. Ooh. Now, saints, here's something I want you to catch. The seer's anointing is connected to what God don't want you to see. The seer's anointing is connected to what God don't want you to hear. You can see what God is not watching and hinder yourself from watching what God is seeing. You hear what I said? You can see what God is not watching, and it could hinder you from watching what God is seeing. A lot of times what you saw is stopping you from seeing in the spirit. Let me just say this and be real raw with you. The reason why Satan created pornography so that you saw something that would arouse you greater than what you could see. Let me say this to you. Some people that are addicted to pornography are really supposed to be prophetic. So what Satan has aroused them with the wrong sight.
Wow.
So what happened is, he know if I get you aroused with this sight, you'll never pursue God for this sight. I done found something to counterfeit the arousal of the sight that God was going to give you for the sight that the flesh is giving you. Since the Bible said Adam sinned and his eyes opened up in the book of Genesis, what was his eyes opening up to? The wrong sight. So he began to see something that was wrong. Imagine this, saints. His sight was in the night. So the demonic took over his sight. It was no longer God ruling his sight. It was the demonic ruling his sight. The Holy Spirit was no longer speaking to him. Now it was Satan speaking to him. Now it was the devil speaking to him. So now he began to see only what the devil sees. He wasn't seeing what the Holy Spirit sees any longer. First he was seeing from the eyesight of God. Now he was seeing from the eyesight of the God of this age. So Satan went from seeing from the eyesight of God to the God of this age. So he went from light to night. Thank you, Prophetess April. That's Genesis chapter 3, verse 7. Thank you. Genesis chapter 3, verse 7. He went from light to night. So he began to flow in the darkness. Listen, whenever you're a prophet, whenever you're a seer, the devil's strategy is to get you into darkness, as always. He's jealous. He knows the ability that God has given you to see. So he wants to arouse a wrong sight. Sometimes you being nosy can be a divine quality to pursue God, not to pursue information. See, curiosity need the velocity of God on it. It needs God impartation on it. Because curiosity was supposed to make you seek Jesus. Not for you to seek information. Not for you to seek toxic news. It was for you to seek Jesus. God picked curiosity in every person to pursue him. But if you're not mature and if you're not focused, you'll let that curiosity come inside of you for you to pursue things that's going to destroy you in the long run. What begins to happen is curiosity has been perverted by Satan. He has corrupted curiosity because Adam had a curiosity to seek God on what the names of the animals was. He had a curiosity to seek God on how to keep and tend the garden. He had a curiosity on how to seek God on how to keep the instruction, which was to be fruitful and multiply, subdue and replenish the earth. He had a curiosity for God. Don't let Satan switch what God has given you. Because everything that God has given you is going to be touched at one point. It's your job to protect it. Some of you all got a mouth that can lay somebody out. Just lay them out. Just, you call them Ed, Mr. Ed. You call them Tutti Frutti on Ludi. You just got a mouth that can just cuss somebody out. Most times, that prophetic zone is in you to speak the word of the Lord to the devil. Not for you to just use it anywhere, but that zone is in you because God gonna use you to speak on his behalf. Very raw things. The toxic fruit that you see on people, a lot of times it stems from something that God gave them that they never submitted it back to God. They never let God take lordship over it. Saints, do you know that most of the people on the earth, Satan is the Lord of something that God gave. So what happened is God gave it, but Satan enslaves it. God gave it, but Satan enslaves it. So you got qualities. Watch this. Some women got qualities to love a man, but you loving all the wrong men. All those things that you can do is wife material. It's not date me for 5 weeks, date me for 2 weeks, date me for 3 weeks. Let's get to know each other. No, you're just wasting your time. You got divine qualities. Watch this. Don't have a wife anointing in a girlfriend mentality. The qualities is in you, but the devil can send all the wrong men to your life, and you use the wrong all these awesome qualities for men. They don't serve God. They don't serve the Holy Spirit. Women were created for men. That's what the Bible says, but for the man of God. A man needs a woman. No man can operate without a woman. Unless he a faggot or he struggle with homosexuality. Well, he still need a woman, because even we see homosexual men still hang with female friends. As a matter of fact, you'd be wondering, how the female friend, listen, they up there with all the cute girls. What? Now, every man needs a woman. A woman that got the anointing to organize things. Woman got the anointing to set things in order. Woman carry the grace of God to release the atmosphere of God to a man's focus. Even if a man is anointed, if a woman is disappointed, the man cannot function in his anointing. Men need women. So every woman has a desire to serve a man of God. But Satan can corrupt that and send all type of Negro men to you. That's full of Negromancy. And then you find yourself pouring out and lavishing the love on them. And they've been sent to destroy you. Isn't it amazing how you can try to preserve something that was sent to destroy you? And so you got to be cautious of that. A lot of qualities that you have are from God. But Satan is using it against you. So the seer's anointing, a lot of times is connected to what God don't want you to see. You keep this anointing strong on you when you guard what you see. And things are always going to pull for your attention that are illegal. It's always going to pull for your attention. If something is illegal, it's always going to pull for your attention. It's always going to try to get you to focus on it. And wrong information is aggressive. That's real powerful. I want you to catch me in the Holy Ghost. Wrong information is aggressive. Saints, do you know that a liar is more persistent than a truth teller? Do you know that a liar is more persistent than truth? A lie is more persistent than truth. Saints, on the day of judgment, on that day when Jesus was about to be crucified, everybody was saying, crucify him. We hardly hear anybody saying, listen, he healed me of leprosy. Don't crucify him. Hey, he fed me and my children. We was a part of the 5,000. Please don't kill this man. We don't see none of them Negroes that Jesus fed. Isn't that amazing? He fed all these Negroes with their children, with their baby kids, all of them. Just fed them, gave them food to eat, clothes to wear, gave them everything. And you don't see none of them stand. Where was the 5,000 when Jesus was about to be crucified? Where was they at? Where was the 4,000 that he fed? Where was the people that he turned the water into wine at the wedding? Where was the people that was at his crusades? Where was the people that brought people that were demon possessed? They got delivered. Where were they? They were thousands. But how come we don't see one stand up? Because lies is more aggressive than truth. Always remember that. Never believe what you hear about a person. Believe what God shows you about a person. Never believe what you hear. Saints, I don't listen to people to decide who people are. I listen to God to decide who people are. Because I know that 90% of people that's going to talk to me about the person is jealous of the person. I know that 90% of people that's going to speak to me about an individual is jealous of the individual that I'm letting close. So I don't wait for individuals to give me sets up. I don't wait for people to tell me, oh, this is what I think. I don't care what you think. I care what God thinks. Because you got to understand, whenever God is sending someone to your life, the majority of voices will be jealous voices. Why? Because they don't want you to experience no favor, no way. Oh, you know what they did, prophet? I don't give up what they did. God said they ain't. If God said they ain't, I don't care what they did. You the accuser of the brethren. And saints, some of y'all say you prophetic, but you can't discern the accuser of the brethren. That's the witchcraft going on in the church. A lot of the people in the church are in witchcraft. Most of y'all that go to buildings are in witchcraft. Because most leaders of this day ain't got no anointing. They just got sermons. Jesus came to a generation of people that was preaching sermons, no demonstration. And then the people that saw him demonstrate and got mad at him because all they did was preach sermons. So their job was to discredit him so the people wouldn't look at them and say, how come all you do is preach sermons? You don't do nothing that this man is doing. You don't cast out no devil. You don't heal the sick, raise the dead, preach the gospel, do the supernatural. As it was then, so it is today. Holy Spirit, when he assigned you to ministry, you can't just be up there preaching. That's all you can do. You got to flow. There's a greater demon fighting people. There's a greater realm of the satanic that's upon people's life. You got to grow. And if men of God don't grow, the people that are underneath the man of God can't. I was speaking to one of my sons about that, my spiritual son. I was telling him that a fast is for people. It's not even for you. But a lot of people have fasted for themselves. I'm fasting to get close to God. No, you fast so that God could kill you so that he can flow through you for someone else to benefit. That's what Isaiah 58 was talking about. Isaiah 58 was talking about you giving your bread to the poor, you being a blessing. Because fasting is where you die to yourself for someone else to live. A lot of stuff that you do is not for you. God gonna make you rich, not just for you. He gonna make you rich. The Bible says, for thou shalt be a blessing. If God healed your body, he gave you that health for someone else to benefit. If God gave you good looks, he gave you good looks for someone else to benefit. There's somebody that's going to be a recipient of who you are. When you stop sowing yourself, you stop growing yourself. When you stop sowing yourself, you stop growing yourself. Growth is connected to unselfishness. Growth is connected to how well you can ignore you. The love of God, it removes you to impart God through you. It removes you. The love of God is one of the most supernatural realms. It's the most supernatural realm because even though you are present, you are still absent. You're there, but you're not functioning. Is God functioning through you? Why did the Bible say love your enemies? God was saying don't function against your enemies. Move out the way and let me function. That's what God was saying. That's why he said love your enemies. He was saying move out the way so I can function. He wasn't saying that your enemy is going to get away. He said, love your enemies. He was saying, let this realm come inside of you. Let this realm take you over where I'm moving. Not you. That's why Apostle Paul said in the book of Acts, in him I live, I move, I have my being. The highest level of the prophetic is love. The highest level of the prophetic is love. Many people want to see all type of stuff except Jesus. That's a witch. There's people that won't see names. They won't see your address. They won't see your car note. They won't see the drawers you're wearing. That's the spirit of Satan. They don't want to see Jesus because there's a thief and a robber. Everybody is praying for the prophetic of God, but not the God of the prophetic. Everybody is crying out for the glory of God, but not the God of the glory. Saints, let me just say this. I don't beg God for his glory. I think that's why he show up so much. There's no other prophet that had the most glory appearances that I've had on live. Never. In meetings, never. But I don't ask God for his glory. I ask him for him. So when I ask him for him, he come. See, so many people are asking for what God is giving instead of what of the giver of what's given. Don't ask for what he given, ask for the giver. If you get the giver, whatever he given will be given unto you. It says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, and all the other things shall be given, added. Get out that realm of trying to get from God and just get God, and everything that he got will come with him. See, saints, watch this here. If you're about to get some bananas and you go to the store, you can be in a place where even though the bananas are there, you want other fruits to be alongside the bananas. But the bananas, if you get the bananas, there might be a deal that's going on. If you get the bananas, then you can get some oranges. You can get some tomatoes. You can get some mangoes, some watermelon, some grapes. Now watch this. You can go ask for mangoes, watermelon, and grapes and all that stuff. Or you can just get the banana, and the grapes and the watermelon and all the stuff will just come alongside of it. This is what a lot of people are doing. Asking for the grapes, the watermelon, and all the stuff. When if you just get the banana is connected to all the grapes, the waters, and all the stuff. Jesus is connected to everything that you want. So when you get, you allow him to possess you and take you over more and more. Now, saints, you become more prophetic when you walk in love more. The more unselfish you become, the more God will show you in your seer's anointing. The seer's anointing is not connected to how well you pray. The seer's anointing is connected to how well you love. If you're taking notes, write that down. The seer's anointing is not connected to how well you pray. The seer's anointing is connected to how well you love. Now, we know that scripture, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Seeing God is the first thing you want to aim as a seer, not seeing people's names. As a matter of fact, they already know their name. That ain't going to deliver nobody. You want to see God so God can show you their future. You want to see God so God can show you stuff that's going to bring change, bring deliverance. Now, the only way for you to get there is to walk in unselfishness. Number one, every seer must sacrifice himself. You become a sacrificial gift to people. You become a sacrificial gift to people. Now, it's not just you operating. You're operating for other people. Your life. Listen, that's why you got to be in the spirit to be around a seer. You got to be in the spirit to be around a seer. You can't be around a seer in the flesh. Because a seer going to do a lot of sacrificial stuff that you ain't going to understand. Because a seer was really sent to live for people, not themselves. So sacrifice. Let me just say this. Some of you all be praying for men of God and be praying for a woman of God. Be careful for what you pray for. Because some of y'all not really there. You asking for a prophet and all this stuff and asking for a man and woman of God. But you don't understand what God is going to do with that man or that woman. They are belonging to him before they're belonging to you. And I've heard people preach all this stuff. Let me just say this. Let me correct this. A lot of people preach talking about family go first before God. That's a doggone lie from the pit of hell. If you don't pick God first, you can't have no family. Because God got to tell you what to do with your family. There's so many people up there talking about people first. That's the stuff why people are turning away from God today. Because it's all about you and your family. It's not about Jesus. It's not about what he wants. So now you done pick everybody before Jesus and then you want Jesus to keep peace in the house. No, he the Prince of Peace, so you better pick him first. You don't pick no family before God. You stupid. Jesus told you if you pick your mother and father before him, you're not worthy of him. If you pick your son and daughter before Jesus, you're not worthy of Jesus. So you really think that because you up there getting some from this man that you're going to pick? You think because you're getting some from this woman that you pick? No, you got to listen to God so that you can know how to treat them. If you don't know how to listen to God, you're not going to know how to treat your husband. You're not going to know how to treat your wife. Because what happened when God speaks to you and you don't feel like doing what God is saying? You don't got no power to do it because all you did was pick family first. You don't got no God first, so you don't have the power to fulfill what he's telling you to do. You just in the flesh. So saints, let me just get that straight for you single people. You better be careful what you ask for. If you want a woman of the Lord, make sure you're ready for a woman of the Lord. Because that woman going to be sold out for Jesus. She going to walk in love. She going to walk in the Spirit. She going to walk in the ways of God. She going to love the Holy Spirit. She going to love what he decided. If you want a man of God, be careful what you ask for. Because a man of God going to be committed. A man of God going to be committed to God's assignment. And let me just say this. For those of y'all that's single, don't be guilty of marrying someone but divorcing their assignment. Oh, Jesus, this is some good stuff right here. You know what I said? I feel my ear burning. That means someone is receiving this word. I feel my ear burning right now. I feel my ear burning right now. Don't be guilty of marrying someone but divorcing their assignment. Anthony Lott, what's up, man? Love you, Prophet. You can't be guilty of that. Make sure if you're going to marry them, you marry the assignment too that's connected to them. If you marry them but divorce their assignment, then their assignment going to get on your nerves. See, saints, I want you to see this. Why did Jesus call us his wife? Because when we marry him, we not only marry him, we marry his assignment. So when Jesus gives us an assignment to love our enemies, we love our enemies because that's what we love him. So we love what his assignment. You hear what I'm saying? See, when you love Jesus, when you become his wife, as a man, as a woman, you not only loving him, you're loving his assignment. You're loving what he instructing you to do. So if Jesus say, go down the street and bless this no good person, you go down the street and bless the no good person. Why? Because you don't just love him, you love the assignment too. What we have a lot of people in the church that love, they love Jesus the best way they know how, but they divorce the assignment. Saints, do you know that Jonah loved God, but he divorced the assignment? He had to get remarried after 3 days. You hear what I said? Jonah had to get remarried to his assignment because he loved God. But he hated the assignment. So he divorced the assignment. He was married to God, but he divorced the assignment. So God said, wait, hold on. Let me just put you in this fish belly, this well belly. Watch. I want you to see something. God had to put Jonah in an animal. Because Jonah had switched to an animalistic mindset towards God. Because he didn't like what God was telling him to do. So God put him in the belly of what he was becoming like in his thought life. And watch, why did God put him in the belly of the well? Because the belly is where food is, where the digestive system is. What God was teaching him how to digest again. So God put him in the belly because God was saying, I need to teach you how to swallow my will. You forgot how to swallow. See, you can't follow until you learn how to swallow. He had to teach him again how to swallow his will. God didn't put him at the head of the well. He put him at the belly of the well because he had to teach him how to digest the will of God again. He had to get remarried to the assignment. What's going to take you through 2018? You better love what God is doing. I see so many saints up there crying. I'm tired of the season. What you tired of the season for? You living a tired life is not a word life. It's not in the word for you to be tired. The Bible said, do not be weary in well doing. So why you get weary? You outside of the anointing. You're not in the spirit. God needs you to be happy about what you're doing. Or he finds somebody else to do it. Saints, we live in a generation, people think that God's going to be sitting down there waiting for you to come around the mountain. Nah, if you don't want to come around the mountain, he's going to find somebody to come around the mountain. If you don't want to do it, God's going to be like, I know somebody who will. Huh? So you better have the right attitude. You better be ready. You better be turned as a man. See, saints, you know, as I'm passionate about this gospel, I preach 7 days a week, pop, 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 pop. 6 hours a day, just pop, 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 pop. This new material, pop, 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 pop. Where do you think I get this stuff from? I don't get it from watching on YouTube. I get it from listening to God, listening to the Spirit of God, listening to the Holy Ghost, spending time with the Holy Ghost. Why? Because you get on fire, you don't want nothing to put the fire out. Why did God show Moses a burning bush? Because he was showing Moses, I want you to be on fire and nothing put you out. I want you to be so supernatural in my fire that you burn full time, 24/7, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. Nothing stopping you. Nothing hindering you. Going forth. God was showing Moses, I want you turned and burnt at the same time. God didn't want Moses up there 1 minute he on fire for God, the next minute he cold. Saints, you know what lukewarm mean? It mean neither hot nor cold. Jesus said, if you neither hot nor cold, I'm going to spew you out of my mouth. I'm not going to have no part with you. So saints, imagine when you neutral, you're in the danger zone. Saints, if you take a notes, write this down. If you give Jesus half of you, you have given Satan all of you. It's a statement that the Holy Ghost had gave me. I'm talking kind of fast because I want to get all this out. When you give Jesus half of you, you give Satan all of you. So listen, if Jesus got 1/4 of you, the devil got 100% of you. Because see, saints, until you give Jesus 100%, he don't see it as 100%. So when you lukewarm, he done spewed you out of his mouth. Why did the Bible say, I'll spew you out of my mouth? So that means that you are positioned in God's mouth. Saints, are you hearing me tonight? This is some powerful stuff. I want you to stay with me. I'm about to get off of here. The Bible said, Jesus said, I'll spew you out of my mouth. So that means that your position in the spirit is in the mouth of God. So watch this, saints. When Jesus said, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceed out of the mouth of God. What Jesus was saying, listen, you're going to live because you're in God's mouth. So watch this. Every time God speaks to you is a new level of life coming upon you. This is why you should obey prophetic instructions, especially from a true prophet of God. I'm not saying from everybody, but make sure, you know, God will position you and show you Because why? The prophet of God is releasing out of the mouth of God, and that's your position. It gives you a new level of life. Now, saints, why did the Bible say he'll spew you out of your mouth? You positioned in God's mouth. So that means that you're positioned in the place of prophecy. Prophecy is not just delivered. Prophecy is a position. You're in the prophetic realm. Because it said that he'll spew you out of his mouth. So that means that you're positioned in his mouth. So you have to make sure that you guard everything that God says to you. Because if you don't, it can remove you from being positioned in his mouth. Now watch this. Here's the scary thing. If you get moved from God's mouth, you enter the mouth of the devil. So there are some people whose life is positioned in the mouth of the devil. That's why he's devouring you through relationships. He's devouring you through wrong people. He's devouring you through wrong thoughts. He's devouring you through wrong words, wrong atmospheres, wrong relationships, wrong connections, wrong company. Because the truth of the matter is, your life can enter into the mouth of Satan. When you see someone as a liar, their life is positioned in the mouth of Satan. When you see someone as a gossiper, their life is positioned in the mouth of Satan. When you see someone's mouth is always tricking people, deceiving, their life is in the mouth of Satan. See, Jesus' mouth was in life was in the mouth of God. That's why he said, "Man shall not live by every word by every by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God." That was his position. The reason why the Father spoke and he told the disciples, "Jesus, this is my beloved Son in whom I well pleased." Jesus' life was in the mouth of the Father. Jesus' mouth was in the life of the Father. That's why the Bible said that when he got on the Mount of Transfiguration, God spoke to him and said, "This is my Son, hear him." Now, saints, this is what I want to tell you tonight. The Seer's anointing, prophetic level 12. The Seer's anointing is connected to what God is connected to what God don't want you to see. Guard your gates. The gates of hell is connected to your gates. This is why you have to fight the good fight of faith. The gates of hell, let me say it like this, are going to attack your gates. So the gates of hell is going to attack your eyes, your ears, your heart. Some of y'all got to go to church tomorrow, but you stand up with the prophet. You're blessed. Blessed be God. You ain't going to learn that no way. I'm giving you that tea. Huh? I said, I'm giving you that tea. Now watch this here. The gates of hell is assigned to the gates of your life. Your eyes, your ears, your heart, your mouth. A lot of times, you're in a season where the gates of hell is attacking your gates. So you're seeing something that's against what God promised you. You're hearing something against what God prophesied to you. You're feeling something against what God imparted to you. You're enduring something that's against what God told you he was going to bring. Because the gates of hell is assigned to the gates that you've been given. So everything that the Lord is going to use to deepen you in the Seer's anointing, you're going to have to learn to protect it from the gates of hell. There are gates in hell. There are gates for lies. There are gates in hell for deception. There's gates in hell for strife. There's gates in hell. You ever been in a place where people don't want peace with you? It don't matter what you do, you try to make peace and they still won't fight. They still want war. The gates of hell of strife is in operation. Like you ever seen that in ministry even? You see some people be the bigger person and be like, listen, let's settle this. And then the other minister still like, no, I'm going to fight. The gates of hell is prevailing of strife. See, Saul had a gate of hell operating against him for David. Saints, I want you to catch this. There was a gate that was open upon Saul's life. This is why he kept trying to kill David. The Pharisees kept on trying to kill Jesus because there was gates of hatred. That's why Jesus said they're going to hate you without a cause, because it was a gate of hatred that was open over the Pharisees. So they hated Jesus. Now, the same way the devil has gates, Jesus has gates. Let me show you Jesus's gates. Jesus's gates is in Psalm 100. It said, enter into his courts enter into his gates with thanksgiving. My God. Saints, do you know that Jesus was releasing the gates of heaven when he took the 5 loaves and he gave thanks? He was releasing the gates. The gates of heaven was being released, but he did it through thanksgiving. That's why he took the 5 loaves and 2 fish and he gave thanks unto the Father. When you're giving thanks to God, you're opening up his gates. See, saints, Apostle Paul was being attacked by the gates of hell. So he overcame the gates of hell by opening up the gates of heaven by giving praise and thanks. Saints, do you see that? He began to give thanks to the Father, and this opened up the gates of heaven that destroyed the gates of hell. So saints, these are little things that you got to catch. You defeat the gates of hell by opening up the gates of heaven through thanksgiving. So saints, watch this. Whenever you're not thanking God, the gates of hell can enter your atmosphere. You hear me, saints? This is real powerful. Whenever you're not thanking God, the gates of hell can enter your atmosphere. A lot of times your atmosphere is being bombarded with the gates of hell because the gates of heaven is not able to stay open. And for it to stay open is not up to God, it's up to you. That's why the Bible said, what did David kept saying? I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Why was David saying that? Because he was saying, I need to keep the gates of heaven open. Prophetic level 12. Thankfulness. That thankfulness increased the prophetic on his life. Thankfulness increases the prophetic anointing on your life. This is how you start flowing stronger with God. Why? Because there's gates open in the spirit. See, saints, the only way you're going to overcome the gates of hell, the Bible says on this, the gates of hell shall not prevail against you. The only way the gates of hell shall not prevail against you, if you learn how to open up the gates of heaven. So you got to learn how to open up his gates. If you don't open up the gates of heaven through thankfulness, you're going to be weary. You're going to be sad. You're going to get depressed. You're going to get tired. You're going to get distracted. You're going to get tempted. You're going to fall to temptation. You're going to fall to lies. You're going to fall to trickery. You're going to fall to wrong things. Toxic things are going to take you over. So it's your job. Jesus stayed in thankfulness. The reason why Jesus stayed in thankfulness was because he knew how to keep the gate open over his life. The gates were so open over Jesus's life. The Bible said that the heavens opened up and the Father sent down the Holy Spirit like a dove. Why was the Holy Spirit able to come down? Because the gates was open. Why did Moses and Elijah appear on the Mount of Transfiguration? Because Jesus was walking in an open gate. So even the gate was so open that he met people that used to live in the former life. The gate was so open that prophets, major prophets, not no weak prophets, major prophets, prophets that were in major, major functionality began to show up because his gates were open. See, he kept his gates open. Saints, if you're going to move into Seer's anointing, learn how to keep your gates open. Keep your gates open for the Spirit of God through thanksgiving, through humility. Humility is another way to keep your gates open. You have to humble yourself underneath the mighty hand of God. If you read the Bible, you'll find that in the Old Testament, the hand of the Lord, the hand of God used to come upon prophets and move them to prophesy. So when you deal with the hand of God, it is dealing with the fivefold ministry. The fivefold ministry, when it say humble yourself underneath the mighty hand of God. The hand of God is a fivefold ministry. So when the Bible said humble yourself underneath the mighty hand of God, humility is when you can submit to someone as unto the Lord. This is why we don't have many people getting exalted in our generation, because people can't submit to someone that God is using. It's such a competition. Humility is when you can submit to someone that God is using. They're the hand of God, apostle, a prophet, a teacher, a pastor, evangelist, apostle and prophet. Let me say something that's real profound. You can't really carry a full knowledge of Jesus unless you have a prophet or apostle. Because the Bible said that the church is built upon the foundation of the apostle and the prophet. So the apostle and the prophet is going to show you how to move in the revelation of Jesus. The prophet is going to show you how to move in the fullness of Jesus. It can't come to you apart from the foundation. Why is it called a foundation? If you look at the word foundation, the first beginning of those words is found. Somebody write me that word right now. Write me the word foundation. Somebody write me that word foundation. That word got the word found in it. Do it on Facebook too. That word foundation, if you look at the first five letters, I believe, first four or five, F-O-U-N-D, you'll get the word found. So the Bible said that the apostle and the prophet is the foundation. So watch this. In order for you to find Jesus, you need an apostle and a prophet found. It means that it's already discovered. Why is it called why is the word found? If something is found, it means that it's already discovered. So what happened? The Jesus is already discovered by an apostle and a prophet. So now they are sent to reveal what was found so that you can find it. Oh, Jesus. So what begins to happen? They're sent to release what was found. It's a foundation. So they found it. And now they're releasing it for you to find it. Oh my God. That's why the Bible said that the straight and narrow path, there'll be a few that finds it. Why? Because the straight and narrow path doesn't come through being solo. The straight and narrow path comes when Elijah comes to your house and say, come follow me. And, the fullness of this come when Apostle Paul say, Timothy, I want you to sit underneath me and imitate me as I imitate Christ. No, I ain't telling you to follow God. I'm telling you to follow me, because God sent me to you. And if you follow me, I know that God gonna do what he wanna do in your life through me. See, saints, you gotta understand the revelation that Apostle Paul was walking in. Apostle Paul didn't tell Timothy to follow God. He said, follow me as I follow God. He said, imitate me. He didn't say be no imitate. He said, imitate me as I imitate God. Why? Because Apostle Paul was dealing with the foundation. The foundation was found by Apostle Paul so Timothy can find it. See, the foundation was found by Elijah so that Elisha can find it. See, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. See, saints, the foundation was found by Naomi so that Ruth could find it. See, Ruth found the foundation. She began to find the foundation that Naomi already had. That's why she said, your God shall be my God. Your people shall be my people. Ruth did not know God. Ruth knew Naomi and Naomi knew God. My God. Say, so Ruth began to know God because of Naomi. Now, if she didn't follow Naomi and went the same path as the other female that was connected to Naomi's son, she would have still been unmarried. She would have still been a widow. She would have still been broke. She would have still, but she believed her prophet. She began to prosper. Why? Because she knew how to build it upon the foundation. I feel the anointing. You can't know the fullness of Jesus until you get connected to a prophet. Because there's signs of Jesus that religion and tradition can't reveal to you. What you think God wants you to do be the stuff that he don't want you to do. Sometimes you offering up stuff to God that he don't really want. But you doing it because you think that it seemeth right to a man. A lot of stuff that that you're taught to do be stuff God don't even want you to do. Saints, God will listen to someone that's running on a track and exercising and praying in the spirit before he listens to someone that's on their knees. Why? Because he's not dealing with you on your knees. He's dealing with the position of if your heart is on its knees. And you can be on your knees, but your heart can be standing up. My God. Listen, and then you can be standing up and your heart can be on your knees. My God. See, so since God ain't dealing with the outward thing. Prophetic level 12. Prophetic level 12. Prophetic level 12. Look at Proverbs chapter 14, verse 12. It said, there's a way that seemeth right to a man, but the end thereof is death. There's a way that seemeth right to a man, but the end thereof is death. There's a way that seemeth right. See, watch. I want you, somebody write me the word seem. I'm going to show you something real powerful. Saints, I feel the anointing. I feel the anointing. Those of you who are joining on, just share this broadcast, invite your followers. Look at the word seem and say, Lord, I receive the prophet's reward. Take the M out. Now watch this. I'm going to show you something. Watch. I want you to take the E and the M at the end of the word seem and flip it around. Take the M at the end of the word seem. Take the M and the E and flip the words around. What word do you get? What word do you get in seem? The last two words, flip it around. Flip the E and the M around. Seem. What do you get? What word do you get? If you flip the last two words around, what word do you get? In the word seem, you get the word me. Now, saints, you get the word me. So in the word seem is the word me. So when the Bible says there's a way that seemeth right, it's just a realm of me. It's not God, it's me. So it seemeth right. So I'm doing this and it's really me talking to me, and I'm doing this and I'm expecting God to receive it. It's just me functioning. I'm acting like God is speaking to me, but it's really me. It's me. Seem, it seemeth right. Now watch this. Let me show you another revelation of the word seem. If you take the S and the E, take the M out. Because the M represent me. Take the M out. You get the word what? In the word seem, you get the word see. You get the word see. Now, I want you to see this. There's a way that seemeth right to a man. So, but the end thereof is death. So, Proverbs 14, 12. So, it means that there's a way where I just see me. Or it's where me see. It's not God seeing through me. I'm not seeing through God. It's not me seeing God. It's me seeing me. There's a way that seemeth right. There's a way that causes me to see from my own point of view. It leads to death. For you to be a seer, you gotta stop doing what seemeth to be right. What seemeth to be right most times is wrong when you're in the prophetic. Remember, Naaman got mad at Elijah because he thought Elisha should have came out and laid hands on him for him to get healed. But he tells him to go dip in the Jordan seven times. So he's telling him to do something that doesn't seem to be right. They have to encourage him to do it. Because in the prophetic, what God wants you to do will always seem like what God wouldn't want you to do. How God wants you to dress will always seem like how God doesn't want you to dress. How God wants you to live will seem like the way that God don't want you to live. Saints, you think that Jesus said, suffer the little children unto me for no reason? Your child got a destiny that's going to be hated by this world. Some of you all want your children to be accredited by this world. Listen, sometimes that ain't the best for your child, especially if your child is a prophetic child. Sometimes the world can't receive, because even the spirit of the world detect the spirit of God upon your child. And God be saying, listen, daughter, I don't really want your son getting no accreditation from this. No way. Your son been called to do something great. I don't want him to get stuck in this accreditation. I don't want your daughter to get stuck in the accreditation of people that's stupid. The world is stupid. They're going to hell. What? The world's stupid. Saints, I know we get all excited about all A's, but all A's don't mean squat to God. This is some raw teaching, but you got to understand that God don't care if your child got all A's. He care about if your child can respect you. He don't care if your child got all A's. He care about if your child can seek him while they're young. God don't care about if your child got no all A's. He care about if your child is growing in the things of God so that he can use them when they get to that age. He says, I got these young men with me, young women with me. What I'm doing? I'm teaching them how to be women of God. I'm teaching them how to be men of God. Because God don't care about all that other stuff. If you can't serve God and put a smile on his face, he don't care if you put a smile on somebody else's face out there. If you can't put a smile on the face of God, you done failed. If people praising you, maybe God is not. You hear what I said? You hear what I said? I said if people praising you, maybe God is not. I'm talking about people in the world, not people in the spirit. People in the spirit, when they praise and give honor, they in the spirit, they discern Jesus. I'm talking about people in the world. If the world is praising you, and listen, what are you doing that the world likes? The Bible says he that is a friend of God is an enemy to this world. The enemy, the world ain't supposed to like you. If the world love you, you ain't walking with Jesus yet. When you a seer, you will be hated by natural people. Let me just say this. Number two, when you're a seer, you will be hated by people that are jealous of the fact that you can see and they desire to see. Saints, do you know that some people that want to operate in the seer's anointing, they will hate you just because you got it? You hear what I said? How many of y'all can relate to this? How many of y'all understand? They will hate you just because you're carrying the seer's anointing. And watch. People that don't have the seer's anointing know when you have it, because they compete with you the most. They'll compete with you the most. They'll fight with you the most. And you don't even be trying to fight them. You be like, praise God. And they be like, no, no, no. Because spiritually, the seer's anointing is a very heavy realm of God. And it causes people that are in the satanic realm to be jealous of you. This is what a lot of people don't understand. People in the satanic realm, they are more keen to be jealous of someone that's prophetic than someone that's just saved. You being saved and all that stuff, you going go to church, that don't faze nobody. Ain't nobody care about you going to no church. Ain't nobody care about you going to no church and you up there sitting down in no church with no hot seat, with a fan in your hand sometimes because of air conditioning. Ain't nobody worry about that. You ain't no threat. You a threat when you start moving prophetically and you start seeing and discerning stuff. The devil like, oh, I got to shut you down. Because if you do this, then you're going to start delivering other people. Because a prophetic anointing makes you a deliverer. Always remember that. A prophetic anointing makes you a deliverer. I'm always having dreams where I'm delivering people. I have dreams. I don't know if some of you all have that too. I always have dreams. I've been having it lately, like where people are in floods and I'm delivering them out the flood. Or people are in fires and I'm running in the house and delivering them out the fire. Or people are being shot and I'm taking the bullet for them. It's all type of stuff I'll be seeing in visions while I'm sleeping. While I'm sleeping for 2 minutes. God got to show me my visions quick. That's a little jokey joke. Only 5 people will understand me. God got to show me my visions quick. I done woke back up. I done saw about 5. I done saw about 50 things. Since I'm learning how to manage this anointing, because listen, you can be so full of God that sometimes you don't need natural stuff. You don't need food. You don't need no sleep. You don't need, you know what I'm saying?
Now there's something, listen, there's certain stuff that you do need, you know what I'm saying? Huh? Listen. Somebody said, I feel the anointing. Listen, I feel it too. What? I feel it strong too, man. Oh, woman, listen, bless you. what's his name? What Bernie Mac used to say? Says white people say God bless the dead. Like, I used to hear people say that growing up. Like, you can't bless no dead person, they dead. How you gonna bless the dead? Now, I said they dead, they you can't bless them. And since I'll be wondering, like, how you? They be like, God bless the dead. I'm like, now watch this here. Let me get back to the subject. Now, saints, when you're a seer, when you're a seer, you gotta know that. You gotta hit the mark that God wants you to hit despite dustiness. No matter what you see, no matter what you feel, no matter what you hear, you got to hit the mark despite dustiness. You got to be in there. You got to be ready to rock and roll. You can't be like everybody else. Listen, people ain't going to understand you, but you got to be ready to rock and roll. Because listen, you're going to have people try to pop up and try to make you feel insecure. Listen, woman of God, let me just tell you this. If God didn't call you with people around, how come you got people around when God called you? You hear what I'm saying? Man of God, if God didn't anoint you when people was around, how come you got people around when God anointed you? So you waiting for a source to confirm his when the source wasn't never created to confirm his. You looking for confirmation when God already gave it to you. Now, that's something that you won't catch as a seer. A lot of time, God done gave you confirmation, but your procrastination, your fear make you operate like you don't. Do you know that you could have knowledge, but fear will make you ignorant? You can be in a position of knowledge, but in a functionality of ignorance. There's a lot of seers that operate like that. You have a position of knowledge, but you have the functionality of ignorance. You have the position of power, but you have the functionality of weakness. You have the position of victory, but you have the functionality of defeat. You have the position of liberty, but you have the functionality of bondage. You have the position of peace, but you got the functionality of confusion. You got the position of health, but you got the functionality of sickness. You got the position of favor, but you got the functionality of insecurity. Bless you, Marvin. Thank you. I received that. What are you dealing with? You got to get your functionality to line up with your divinity. God already got it there, but you got to submit to what God already put there. What was Jesus doing? Jesus was submitting to what was inside of him, not what was outside of him. The disciples submitted to what was outside of them, but Jesus submitted to what was inside of him. Jesus submitted to the Spirit of God inside of them. The disciples submitted to the spirit of the storm on the outside of them. Jesus had to teach them how to bring the spirit of the storm outside of them to submit to the Spirit of God inside of them so that they can move. Imagine that, saints. Jesus had to teach them how to function from inside. Those of you on Facebook, follow me on Periscope. Bless you. You got to learn how to function from the inside. You got to learn how to function from the inside. The inside is where God is. He's not on your outside. So sometimes you trying to find God from the outside and he's not found from the outside.
What happens when your location is not carrying where God is? God is not there, but you there. Never be where God isn't. Never let your feet go Jesus was teaching them the inside function. When you're a seer, learn to function from the inside. When you're a seer, learn the functionality of the inside. This is how you're going to see more. Stop looking at people from the outside. That's how you miss blessings. The Bible said, God rebuked the prophet and said, stop looking at the outward appearance. If you look on the outside, you ain't going to reap no harvest from God because your outside ain't showing no money. You don't know where no money going to come from. Most times you don't even know much people. But saints, I'm a living witness that the seed brought me out. I sold seed and God connected me to men that I knew for years. On TV, I ain't know them in person. I ain't know no Dr. Mike Murdoch. I saw Dr. Mike Murdoch playing his keys and whatnot. I used to see Dr. Mike Murdoch. I said, dude, this old man, you know, I used to see him as the wisdom, he older man, the wisdom. I didn't know who Dr. Mike Murdoch was. I just used to watch him as a little boy. And then his songs used to take me away. And he used to sing. And then saints, when he preached, he'd be like, everybody just turn to your Bibles. And I always thought that he sounded like God. Now saints, Dr. Mike Murdoch have scared me a couple of times because I used to be walking sometimes. He'd be like, son. Or he'd be like, Prophet Joshua. And I'm like, listen, Jesus, it's time for me to go. Listen, I'm ready if you want me, Lord. Listen, I got 5 more minutes, Jesus. I'm trying to get something done right here. But listen, if you want me, I can go. Huh? I lay it down. Huh? I lay it down. Just 5 more minutes, Jesus. But listen, I lay it down. About 20 more minutes. I lay it down. All right, it was just add 15 more minutes. I lay it down. say, Dr. Mike Murdoch, listen, I used to see Dr. Mike Murdoch. I used to wonder, would I ever meet somebody like Dr. Mike Murdoch? Because, you know, and then they used to come on like 3 a.m. in the morning. Yeah, I used to love Dr. Mike Murdoch, too. I used to love him even before I met him. I used to love his ministry and everything. So yeah, so sometimes I'd be just walking, I'd just say, son of Prophet Joshua. And I was like, Jesus, you calling me already? You ain't even give, listen, Jesus, at least warn me next time. Cause listen, I just have 5 more minutes. You know, you know, Bible said, taste and see that the Lord is good. So, you know what I'm saying? So saints, I didn't know. I didn't know I was going to meet Dr. Mike Murdoch. I met Dr. Mike Murdoch off of a seed, just sowing money and believing the instruction of the Holy Spirit. I was just like a receiver of God's instruction concerning money. I didn't know that I was going to meet no Dr. Mike Murdoch. I met Dr. Mike Murdoch off of seed. God spoke to me and told me, you're going to sow these $4. He going to call you at 4 p.m. And it's going to be like the fourth of like something. Then he said $400. Everything was a fault. Everything was a fault. Now, saints, at the time, that was my highest because I had just gave away everything I had. That was my highest. You got to understand, some of y'all want to sow $4 seed and you got $4,000 range. That was my highest at the time. Because I had already done gave. Listen. So for me, that was a stretch. Yeah, because saints, when you tip God, you don't get nothing. You just get a tip. God be like, listen, the tip is wait on me. See, saints, that's a revelation right there. When you tip God, you just get a tip. He just, let me give you a tip. Just wait on me. I'm coming soon. And say, Jesus be laughing. Jesus be like, I ain't coming down there with the broke self. I need him to come up higher and trust me higher. And say, sometimes Jesus be laughing. He be laughing. Say, But see, sometimes Jesus be laughing. He be laughing at folk. He be like, listen, you really think I'm going to come down there you with your broke tail? You don't believe me for nothing. I'm trying to raise you higher. Until you show me that you believe me, then I can come down. The saints, let me ask you a question. How come you got a big future but a small obedience? See, some of y'all need to catch me in the Holy Ghost. How come you got a big future but you got small obedience? You better come up higher in 2018 and stop playing around with God. Stop playing around with the Spirit of God. Stop trying to trick God. You better come up higher and start moving stronger in your obedience and stronger in your submission and you're stronger in your surrender. Stop playing around with the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost can't be fooled. He's just going to pass you over when it's time to bless you. Because the same way you saved your life, he's going to make sure your life stay where it was. For the people that lost their life, he's going to say it's time for you to come up. Because you trusted me. You walked on the water with me. So let me put you in a place where you never have to walk on water again. When you don't walk on water, God be like, nah, you got to come around this mountain again and walk on this water. Well, let me not say come around the mountain. You're going to have to move around this mountain. And move around this mountain and let's see if you're going to walk on this water. Because God needs to see you do it before he can bless you through it. Always remember that. God needs to see you do it before he can bless you through it. He don't need no surface obedience. He needs you. He don't need surface obedience. He needs obedience that removes the surface. If you take a note, write that down. I just heard the Holy Ghost say that. I'm about to get off of here, Luke. Y'all heard me preach like a crackhead tonight. Tyrone Biggums. Watch this here. He don't need you, your obedience to be on the surface.
What you want from me?
Saints. Imagine.
What you want from me?
He don't need your obedience on the surface. He don't need surface obedience. He need obedience that removes the surface. Huh? He need obedience that moves the surface. Because he need to take you deeper. He need to scuba dive you. Huh? Huh? You need to come up higher. Huh? Now watch this. It's the risky obedience that produces heavenly results. If you take notes, write this down. It's the risky obedience that produces heavenly results. See, that there's a level of faith that heaven needs to come down. See, I want you to hear me. Your sacrificial obedience is the GPS of heaven. So heaven can't locate you until there's sacrificial obedience. You hear what I said? This is some powerful stuff. Sacrificial obedience is the GPS of heaven. So heaven can't locate you until it sees sacrificial obedience. And thank you, Keisha. It's the risky obedience that produces heavenly results. God needs to see you step out your comfort zone so that he can produce a new comfort zone for you. Oh my God. Did you hear what I said? This is some powerful stuff. This is some powerful stuff. I feel lit right now. Hold on, says I'm going to get off of here. God needs you to come out your comfort zone for him to produce a new comfort zone for you. See, saints, what we got to understand is when God gets you out your comfort zone, it's not for you to be uncomfortable. He gets you out your comfort zone so that he can create a new level of one, so that he can create a new zone of one, so that he can create a new operation of comfort. He not getting you out your comfort zone for you to live a life where you always awkward. Though he does require awkwardness. You can't be anointed and not get awkward. You got to be awkward for a minute. Listen, God will have people fight you just so that you can get awkward. Because until you get awkward, you'll never depend on him to balance you.
Oh my God.
See, if you already balance, his instructions are going to be awkward. But if you awkward, his instructions are going to be balanced.
Oh my God.
Says that, what? Now says, hear me. You hear what I said? Says I'm about to get off of here. If you balance, God's instructions will be awkward to you. But if you are awkward, his instructions will be balanced to you. It'll bring balance to you. It'll cause you to stand again. So he needs you on the wild side sometimes. If you're not on the wild side, you're not on the child side sometimes. You're still trying to be an adult. And when you try to operate towards God as an adult, you step into a cult. When you step into a cult, huh? About to peel off, huh? When you step into a cult, then you step into spiritual witchcraft. When you're rebelling against God with a seed but still expecting a harvest. You're rebelling against God with your life, but then you get mad when it produces death. See, saints, you got to catch that. When you rebel against God with your life, it produces death. See, saints, there's a reverse effect. If you don't give God your life, it produces death. It causes things in reverse. It causes a curse. Now, saints, it's the risky obedience that produces heavenly results. Your harvest comes after your hardest season. Your harvest season comes after your hardest season. Now, let me say it like this. Your harvest season come after your hardest season. Watch this here. If you're taking notes, write this down also. God cannot bless you with a harvest season until your heart is seasoned. That's some good stuff right there. Saints, I want you to take notes and write that down. We're about to get off of here. But I'm giving you some one-liners. Somebody wipe me down. I'm giving you some one-liners. God can't give you a harvest season until your heart is seasoned. So God needs to see that your heart is seasoned. He needs to see that your heart is in a place where it's mature enough. He needs to see that your heart is in a place to carry the weight of financial glory, carry the weight of marriage glory, carry the weight of children glory, carry the weight of ministerial glory, prophetic glory, apostolic glory. He need to know pastoral glory. He need to know virtuous woman glory. He need to know if you're able to carry man of God glory. There's angels all around me. There's angels all around. There's angels all around me. Angels all around. There's angels all around you. Oh, angels all around. There's angels all around you. Oh, angels all around. There's angels all around me. Angels all around. There's angels all around me. Oh, angels all around. There's angels all around me. Angels all around. There's angels. Oh, yes, yes. There's angels. Oh, yes, yes. There's angels, oh, oh, angels. There's angels, oh yes, angels. Saints, you know why I teach more than I prophesy? I prophesy through my teaching? Because saints, I'm in the presence of God. See, Jesus was a teacher. He heard from God because the presence of God was there. Listen, if you ever want to know who Prophet Joshua Holmes, study the fruit. You don't even need to be around me. Just study the fruit. Could God proceed from a field? No. And I hear people always tell us God can use anybody. That's a doggone lie. God is a king. He ain't trying to put himself in no dustiness. You got to purify yourself. He told the children of Israel, purge yourself, sanctify yourself, and I'll do wonders among you. God said, if you don't sanctify yourself tomorrow, I ain't coming down. If y'all up there smelling like chiwis and you smelling like hot sex and wrong sex, you smelling like sin and the devil is your twin, I'm not coming down until you sanctify yourself. God wasn't coming down. God wasn't coming down to nothing and nothing. We up there trying to put God in this boat. Oh, he can use anybody. Saints, God ain't trying to use anybody. He trying to use somebody that got the right heart to be used. That's a cliche. There's a preference that God has. He ain't trying to come down. You up there smelling like your ex. Huh? Sharika said hot booty and ketchup. Listen, Sharika, what just happened? What just happened, daughter? Shamel, you better not yell at your workplace. Turn the volume down. Turn the volume down, Shamel. You're going to scare the patient. You can't be scaring people around you. God can't come down. You up there smelling like the world. No. God need to smell himself when it come down. You can't be up there smelling like chiwis and tell us God use anybody. No. God need to smell his fragrance around you. Huh? He need to smell his presence around you. Huh? Before he peeled off. You come down up there smell like, what's going on? Saints, you know how many angels done came to people's house and then smell something in the room and said, let me get out of here. I'm at the wrong place. I thought when I came down here I was going to see some worship, some bow down and worship. But I done came into something that smelled like hell and sulfur. Huh? Wake yourself up! I done woke up about five people just now. Five people just woke up. Watch them, watch them. They're picking up the phone right now. Watch them, watch them, watch them. Wait, saints, wait. Wait. Now watch this here. Huh? God needs to smell himself when he come down. Hey. Hey, one time, saints, you know. Hey, saints, y'all know, it says in my meetings, I be rolling. Like, I be going like 48 hours, no sleep. I come in the room like I had 5 hours, like 50 hours of sleep. I be lying. I just come in the room. I ain't. My meetings, I be rolling. I be up like 48 hours just. Now, watch this. Say, one time I had Lemon with me. And I told Lemon, I said, Lemon said, can I go to the room? Now watch this, saints. I told Lemon. Lemon said, can I go to the room real quick? I'm going to come right back. I said, Lemon. Yeah, son, you can go to the room. You come right back. About 6 hours went past. Lemon went to that room. Lemon was passed out. He was not. Now it's just gone. God says if you saw him, you would have thought he was dead right there. He was like, listen, somebody done killed him on. It says he was right there, knocked out. I'm like, listen, what just happened to Lemoon? Listen, check his pulse. I'm trying to tell you. I'm saying, ain't nobody fault. I just be in that 48-hour zone. Not saying Jesus don't go to sleep. I don't be going. Listen, I'll be right there with Jesus. I'm like, Jesus, what you doing? He like looking at you. I'm looking at you, dude. Jesus, I'm looking at you. I'm looking at you at the same time. Listen, you looking at me, Jesus? Listen, Jesus, I'm looking at you too. The angel. Listen, the angels be up there. The saints, how you think I'll be able to talk to my angels? Because they be up at the same time. Like, angel, what you doing? Listen. Saints, I got one of my angels that called me prophet. He didn't call me Joshua. He called me prophet. He called me after my office. And they're very respectful. They don't even care about honoring men of God. They're very humble. You want to know where humility abides? It abides in the angel. Angel called me. Me and him both respect each other. I decree stuff to him. He be like, I'm going to do it. And he really do it. I've seen this angel move so many times in my life. There are angels that listen. They be functioning. They be ready to go. That says, listen, you can't get your angel to move and you smell like chewies. That says, even your angel know. You smell to your angel. Your angel know when you're in sin. Because you smell like it. You know, angels can smell you spiritually. There's a realm in the discerning of spirits that you can smell. Huh? Chee-wees. You can't be smelling like chee-wees. Angels, the discerning of a spirit. In the discerning of a spirit, you can smell demons. You can smell angels. My sons tell me that they smell me. Now, me and them never... I've never slept physically in a bed with my sons. I've never been in a same bed. But they said they can smell me when they go home. Why? Because the fragrance of the Lord. And smell the fragrance. The fragrance, it continues even when I'm absent. That saints. Jesus is a man. He's not a woman. But I love Jesus as a man. That's the only man I really love. Like, I'd do anything for. But Jesus, we forget that Jesus is a man. He's not a female. Since one time Jesus made a joke to me, he said, son, I didn't have to have intercourse when I was down here. I didn't have to have sex with nobody. He said, I used you all's body to do it for me. I didn't have to get married. I use y'all to get married for me. You understand that the Bible said that you're the body of Christ? You're the body of Christ. He's using your body to fulfill the life. That's why Apostle Paul said the life that I now live in the flesh is by the faith of the Son of God. It was the life that he now lived in the flesh. Somebody said I almost fell out my bed. I told you. That shout be loud. It be wild. Huh? That shout. Some of y'all don't wipe your eyebrows off. You ain't got your eyebrows on. Listen. You done got too comfortable, huh? You done wiped your eyebrows off. Listen. If somebody see you, they gonna look at you like that. Like, girl, hey, where you at? Listen, is that you? Chiquita. Listen, somebody done came in the house. It'd be like, hey, Shaquita, hey, Kool-Aid. So, somebody that came in the house, listen, call 911. Say, isn't it funny how people tell you call 911 and you they the one that got the phone? Like, listen, somebody that came in the house, call Kool-Aid. Call the Kool-Aid. Listen. Nah, she went to sleep with eyebrows on. No, that's not her. They be like, nah, that is her. Nah, when she went to sleep, she had on eyebrow. Nah, that's not her. Her eyes like this here. Nah, that, listen, this a ghost. I'm saying, what goes on, man? And since you don't want somebody to wake you up and then they ain't got no eyebrows on, listen, it's scary. All right, listen, listen, Saints, what if your child cut off their eyebrows? Like, Mom, I'm hungry. Like, well, listen, there's Chucky in the room. Listen, there's Chucky in the room. Listen, Saints, you don't know what to do. You know what I'm saying? How many of y'all remember Chucky? Saints, there's some scary stuff, man. Yeah, some of y'all done got too comfortable. You done took your eyebrows off. You done took your wig off. You know what I'm saying? This is, we can't recognize you right now. Huh? 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 Listen, you done took everything off. Like, you done gone. Huh? You can't be up there just going on like this here. You don't got your Fruit of the Loom on. This ain't right. You gotta keep them eyebrows on. Listen, them eyebrows, they done came too far to look back. You hear what I said? You done came too far. Now, Saints, what be funny to me, some people tattoo their eyebrows. I've known men that do that. I won't do that, I promise God. But I know some men that tattoo their eyebrows, so they always look like this. Nah, they always look like this. Like, look. Bruh, what you see in the room, you see a roach? And Saints, watch this here. Watch this here. You don't know if a roach really in the room, because they always looking at you like this. Like, hey, there's a roach in the room. He's saying a roach in the room. See, you don't even know. He says you don't even know, because Saints, when the eyebrow get tattooed, then you stay in the same position all the time. So like, even when you dead at your funeral, like, you be thinking like, he ain't really dead. You just slap him one time. Just wake yourself up. Because you just want to check, make sure that it's not that the eyes like that, but that the life really gone. Saints, I couldn't go to no funeral, because I don't want to see nobody dead. I only want to see you when you're alive. If God ain't telling me to raise you up, then I don't need to come to see you. Just give me a picture when you was alive. That's all I needed. I'm saying, that thing be scared. You up there see somebody in the tomb and they ain't moving around. Nah, I can't do that. And then Saints, listen, dead people makeup be on fleek though. Saints, you ever seen a dead person makeup? Like, they be looking like, have you ever seen a dead person makeup? Nah, Saints, nah, something be wrong. Like a spirit of lust just come over. Listen, that was, like, girl, listen, you ain't look like this when you was on earth. How you gonna look like this when you dead? Huh? When there's no beneficiary to this. Huh? You ever seen that before? It's just shocking. It just messed you done messed you up. Saints, I know some of y'all done that. Listen, how many of y'all done been to a funeral? Saints, I can't stand a funeral, Saints. And then Saints at the funeral, they be lying. You know the man was a liquor drinker. You know he was a liquor drinker. You know. But what happened? He still be doing the same. They have the man preaching. The man be like, listen, he lived a holy life. he was such a righteous man and prayed it. You be like, listen, no, he was drunk last week. Saints, you ever seen that before? Saints, in all jokes aside, you be like, nah, I know him. He was listening to Tupac pour out a little liquor just the last week. But he didn't know that was his last piece of liquor. Saints, I remember when I was younger, they told me to preach a eulogy. And I said, no, I ain't preaching no eulogy. Because God ain't going to get me hemmed up and say I'm lying for this man. I know who this man was. I got to keep it 100. Then they're going to preach me. They're going to try to kick me off this place, because they're going to realize that this is a man up there telling the truth. I couldn't lie. I could not lie. I had to make up in my mind. No, I'm, listen, I need to be honest. I don't I don't want to lie up in here. The man had Hennessy last week. Now I can't do it. And since they got mad at me, they were like, no, we want you to preach. No, I said, no, I can't do it. Because there's a tight spot. Because listen, how you going now if you know that some person died like this, like you know that they died doing this. But then you still going to stand up there and preach? You can't do that. You got to be honest. And saying sometimes you know people went to hell. Sometimes they tell you that people, you don't know if people went to hell. You be knowing people went to hell. You know they went to hell. Because listen, some people they let you know, listen, I ain't worried about Jesus. I ain't trying to get saved. I ain't trying to get delivered. I want to live this life. They let you know. And some people are okay with going to hell. But saints, let me give you a secret. When you're about to die, the spirit realm becomes very real to you. When you're about to die, you will start seeing spirits. You will see. You will know if somebody is on their way to hell. You'll hear them say, listen, I feel heat at my feet. Or some people will say, I see people in my room. Or they come get me. Some people really die bad. Especially if you are a nurse or you ever been in the doctor's. People really do operate in the spirit when they're about to die. Your senses come alive. You can see where you're about to go. Angels come get some people. Some people see Jesus. But if someone lived a bad life, they see the demons that possess them. Them demons that possess you, they talk to you. Now you get to see the demon. It's no longer the spirit inside of you just manipulating your mind. Now you get to see them in visible form. And they know you. They're spiders. There's ants that speak in hell. There are demons that speak in hell that are in animal form, but you can't see them. A lot of times buildings in America, I don't know if some of you have ever seen some of them big buildings, they have spiders over them. Why do they have spiders over them? Because it's a circle, it's a web of wickedness that goes on in the building. So the building is covered with that spider. Spirits have form to them. And some spirits, people don't even know were on them when they're about to die. Everything comes open. So I don't know if some of you ever had that experience with somebody dying and they're like, I feel heat. I'm hot. Get me some water. Have you ever seen somebody about to die and they like, get me some water? Why are they telling you get them some water? They entering into hell. That's what's going on. That's why they ask you for water. They're asking you for water because the water is to take, they're trying to get a natural solution to a spiritual reality. What did the rich man ask Lazarus for in hell? He asked them for water. That's what happened. Saints, remember in the text, it was Lazarus that the rich man was saying, just give me a cup of water. The rich man was trying to get water for a spiritual reality, but he wanted natural water. He said, just a drop. Imagine that. So saints, the rich man, his senses was alive. Saints, when you pass from this life, your senses are going to be so alive. Listen, that's why you want to grow in the Seer's anointing now, where Jesus can show you what to fix now. You wait until you go, then when you're going to regret. You're going to see that people were spiders. People that came back into your life and they was trying to get you back into a web. Now, saints, what happened is a relationship. Say you with a girl and you a man. That relationship, if God cut it off, is illegal. Anytime you try to rekindle that, is a spirit behind there. You're going to see the spirits when you die. You're going to see the spirits behind people why God was telling you, don't go back to that man relationship. I have a new husband for you. You're going to understand why he was speaking in those terms. Because there's a spiritual reality that you can't see. But saints, people when they're dying, they can see. They can see. They know their destination. They know whether they're going to heaven or hell. Now saints, let me just say this. When people die, some spirits roam the earth. I'll talk about this later on today, probably later on this Sunday. Some people, their spirit, it possesses family members. It possesses individuals that are in the proximity. It could be if a man was married, he'll possess the house or possess the home or possess the people of the family. Some spirits don't enter into hell immediately. They get judged, but they don't enter into hell immediately. Remember, Legion had the spirits of people that were dead. So how come the people that were dead, how come they was not in hell? They was inside of Legion. When Jesus casted them out, they begged Jesus not to send them to the abyss. Because they knew that that was their destination. They was hiding in Legion. Now, spirits be knowing. Spirits be knowing. Spirits be knowing. So they know. And watch this. Remember what the demon told Jesus. The demon told Jesus, I don't. What did the demon tell Jesus? The demon said, don't cast us out before time. So even evil spirits understand timing. Evil spirits know when hell is closely approaching them. So that's why when a demon is leaving your life, it'll cause the most ruckus in your life. Always remember that, woman of God. When you're getting delivered, man of God, when you're getting delivered from a spirit, you'll be crying, you'll be angry, you'll be frustrated. There's such a ruckus that's going in your life. Why? Because you're being set free from a strong man. The spirit don't want to leave. It don't want to leave you. So you'll be acting out. You'll be rebelling. You'll be shutting down people that you know got the right voice. You'll just be in this place of carelessness because that spirit don't want to leave you. But that's the last stage. If you ever got delivered from a man or a woman that you were in relationship with, you'll find that there was a season where you was crying. Or there was a time, it might have been short, where you was crying, where you was going through withdrawals. Withdrawals? Nah, say, listen, hold on, I ain't, listen. You're crying out. Why? Because there's a deliverance going on. You're being set free. So what happened? You feel it. You feel it. There's a setting free. God saying, no, I know that this is going to hurt, but I got to break you loose. Saints, the spirit world is real. I'll talk about it more later on tonight. People, before they die, they know their destination. When you go to hell, hell has creatures that you'll see on this earth that are down there in hell. There are many demons that have the face of a man but the body of an animal. Ants can speak to you down in hell. Spiders can speak to you down in hell. Now, spiders move more so in that realm of deceit and trickery and deceit. You know, when people get you riled up and stuff and get you tied up into drama. When people get you tied up into things that's not going to benefit your anointing, you done stepped into the realm of spiders. If you can see spirits, you'll be more wise in your decision making. Because sometimes you don't even know that there's a spirit connected to the thought you're thinking. And you don't, watch this, some of you all will fight a spider if it comes on your body. But how about a spider come in your mind? There are people that fight a spider. If a spider is on you, you'll knock it off. But you know how many spiders are in your mind when you're thinking wrong thoughts? The spirit is a spider where the devil got your mind in a web. Like you can't come out of thinking what you're thinking. There's a spider in your mind. Saints, imagine some of y'all will run from a rat. But do you know that when you do certain things where you in the traps of Satan, when you're in the traps of the enemy, there's a rat inside of you. Think about that. So saints, the spirit world is real. Some people have, in witchcraft, there are some demons that look like birds. In witchcraft, there are some demons that look like crow birds. Look like weird type of birds. If you have a dream where a bird is attacking you, it's witchcraft. The powerful thing about God telling Elijah that the ravens was going to feed him was that the ravens represented witchcraft. God was showing him, listen, I'm going to have the ravens feed you. Imagine that, saints. I'm going to take what's of witchcraft and make it submit to your provision. Oh my God, saints, that's a good place to preach right there. I'm going to take what's of witchcraft and make it submit to your blessing. So saints, you have dreams of birds. I'll talk about this probably later on. Saints, prophetic partakers, we lit in there. Every one of you are, those of you all that sow your seeds into JHM, I'm going higher. I'm taking you higher with me. The anointing is flowing. The power of God is on me. It's amazing. Those of you all, get prophetic partakers. We're on Facebook live videos. It's supernatural. Ah! It's glorious. Saints, those of you all, Toya, where you at? Come on down. We get it popping. The woman of God and the man of God is coming forth. You're going to love Jesus and serve Jesus with all of you and bring forth every fruit of the Spirit in your life. It's a blessing. It's a blessing. The glory of God is there. The glory of God is there. So powerful. So powerful. So powerful. So powerful. But saints, if you can see in the spirit, you're no animals are connected to a lot of things that God is telling you to get away from. But you can't see the spirit. God, through the discerning of spirits, will open up your eyes. There's so many ministerial gifts that are opening up right now for you. I feel it. In the name of Jesus, as I'm speaking to you, as I'm imparting to you, as I'm pouring out, I'm going to pour out myself all this year. I gave Jesus my vow. I'll pour out myself in every realm. It's happening for you. The activation of the gifts of the Holy Spirit is happening for the blessing of other people, so that you could be able to be a blessing to them and deliver their life. Remember, all this stuff that God will activate in you is for the benefit of other people. You're living a life of sacrifice for others. Here's the beautiful thing. If you live for someone else, God will have someone live for you. You hear me? Here's the powerful thing. And I want you to remember this statement. If you live for someone else, God will have someone live for you. It's supposed to be a cycle. Love was supposed to be a cycle, not hatred. Hatred has been being recycled. Huh? No. Hatred has been recycled. No, love was supposed to be recycled. You live for someone else, God has someone live for you. The woman at Zarephath, she lived for Prophet Elijah. God had blessings and favor live for that woman at Zarephath. It was a cycle. There's angels all around me. There's angels all around. There's angels all around me. Angels all around. There's angels all around me. Oh, angels all around. There's angels all around me. Oh, yes. You on this line, say, Jesus, forgive me of my sin. I repent. I forgive those that have sinned against me. And I receive your spirit. Take me over, Jesus. That's all I want this year. Take me over, Jesus. Angels all around. Prophetic level 12. There's angels all around me. Oh, angels all around. There's angels all around me. You know what the Lord told me? Those of you out there are my partners and you sow your seed into JHM, God is opening up your eyes to see angels. He's opening up your eyes to flow in the supernatural for the glory of Jesus Christ. He's causing your eyes to see and your ears to hear. Your discerning of spirits is going to be so amazing. You're going to smell things. You're going to hear things. You're going to know things. There's angels all around you. More so, Jesus is going to visit some of you all. So amazing. You're going to see his beauty, his glory, his awesomeness, the substance of his beautiful presence. There's angels all around me, oh, there's angels all around, oh yes. There's angels all around me, oh, angels all around. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I pray for those that are on this line. I pray, keep them, Jesus, protect them. In the name of Jesus, I command your cancer to go. Be of good cheer. In the name of Jesus, I command you to be healed in your body from cancer. Don't worry, you shall come back with a testimony. You shall come back with a testimony. Don't worry, you'll come back with a testimony. The Holy Spirit shall do it for you. I release the anointing where you are in Jesus' mighty name. Saints, stay focused. There's angels all around me, oh, angels all around. Receive healing. Receive angelic ministry in your life. Receive the anointing. There's angels all around, oh yes. There's angels all around me, oh.